My name is Dr. James Colasurdo. I have been a registered Republican all my life until the disaster of Donald Trump. You know, I grew up around New York City. I have friends who worked for Donald Trump on a consulting basis, and they're still looking to get paid. I know about Fred Trump with the anti-discrimination lawsuit in Brooklyn and Queens, prohibiting black folks from renting apartments. I also knew about the Central Park Five, the five young African-American men who were charged with rape and later acquitted. Donald Trump, as you may remember, took out a full-page ad calling for the death penalty against these young men. One of the things that bothers me most about Donald Trump is this is a man who really is not interested in information, learning, knowledge. But his biggest failure is his willful failure to understand science and respect science. He refused to model wearing a mask, knowing full well as a reality TV star that what he said people pay attention to. He has been willfully ignorant and duplicitous and sociopathic, which has now to this date cost 140,000 and up deaths. There is blood on his hands in this epidemic, as far as I'm concerned. I'm going to support Joe Biden, and I'll tell you why. The psyche of the country right now, the mood, the zeitgeist, we are very divided, angry, bitter, and partisan. If Joe Biden stands for anything, I know it's for amity, empathy, and bringing us together. We need it desperately. Donald Trump is a divider. He has psychopathology that is so deep that for me to explain it might take a long time. And I don't like to talk about diagnosis in my field. I'm a psychologist, working psychologist. But since his niece's book came out, it's pretty much in the public record what kind of a narcissist and sociopath Donald Trump is. If you're on the fence about voting for Donald Trump, when you think about the duplicity of this man, the mental cognitive limitations of this man, the insincerity of this man, if you can tell me you feel good with him as our leader, then vote for him again. But if you have any doubts at all, get off the fence and vote for Joe Biden.